my friends, I'm Frankie. Welcome to Club Foodie. Any home chef has to master a few basics, and that includes the classic five French mother sauce. There's béchamel, espagnol, sauce tomate, velouté, and hollandaise. Now, under each of them, there's what I call secondary sauces. In this video, I'm showing you another great one that is a béchamel derivative. In today's episode, I'll show you how to make sous vide sauce. I love this onion sauce. It's so versatile as it pairs amazingly well with poultry, pork, beef, and even game meats. Creamy, rich, and velvety. This is an excellent sauce to add to your folder. So my friends, let's get cooking. In a large pot over medium-low heat, we'll add butter and lots of it. When it's melted and starts sizzling, we'll add onions and some ground sea salt, which will help them to swim. We'll stir very well so they're nicely coated with the butter, cover, and cook until soft and translucent, about 20 minutes, stirring occasionally. Now, let's make sure they don't brown. We want nice and soft, that's all. While the onions are cooking, we'll start the béchamel sauce. I'm not going into details how to make it because I already have in a previous episode. So to get the recipe, click on the top right corner of your screen. The only thing though I want to mention is we'll season with freshly ground black pepper and ground sea salt, but no nutmeg like we regularly add in the béchamel. Alright, back to the onions. When time is up, we'll remove the lid and look at them. Perfectly cooked and not brown at all. So what we'll do is to let the liquid evaporate, which should take about 10 minutes, and we'll stir often during that time so they're still light and creamy. Next, we'll remove from the heat and transfer the onions to the bowl of a food processor. We'll puree them until we have a nice smooth texture. It won't take long, between 15 to 20 seconds. When this step is done, we'll add the pureed onions to the béchamel sauce. On medium heat, we'll stir these two ingredients very well and bring the mixture to a simmer. Now, this is when you're the boss of your own sauce. Depending on what you'll be serving it with, you can add tomato puree, spices, some herbs, and so on. Because it's sweet, I like to add hot paprika. Not a lot, but just enough to balance out the sauce. Like I always say, don't forget to taste and adjust if necessary. And that's it. We're ready to serve. Otherwise, place some wax paper on top to prevent a skin from forming and move it back to the back burner, keeping it warm until needed. And my friends, this is our sous vide sauce. Creamy, smooth, and tasty, this is an excellent choice for enhancing your dinner. This recipe is pretty easy and straightforward, so elevate your grilled chicken or pork chops with this beautiful secondary sauce from béchamel. I hope you give it a try soon, and be sure to visit clubfoodie.com for ingredient amounts, directions, and more info. Until next time, my friends, bon appétit!